good? I'm CatLife. Nice to meet you. All right, let's talk about runes. Let me show you the two pages I use most of the times. The first one I'm going to show you is the Electrocute page. I go Electrocute, Sudden Impact, Eyeball Collection, Relentless Hunter, Secondary Precision, going Triumph and Coup de Grace. So first off, let's talk about Electrocute. It's got good burst, which synergizes well with Katarina's bursty assassin playstyle. It helps you push for those one-shot assassinations for picks or resets in fights. The damage is upfront too, so it's quick and hard to react to and can catch people off guard. And it's also easy to proc, so you just have to hit 3 abilities or attacks, or you can just hit 3 ticks of ulti. So you can be pretty flexible with the way you proc it. Because of this, it's a good way to get safer pokes and trades in lane. Now going down the tree, we have Sudden Impact, which I think is really good because it gives 6 magic pen and you're going to be proccing it all the time because you're going to be using your Shunpo a lot. On some occasions, I do take Taste of Blood for difficult melee matches just for the sustain in lane, but if you don't need it, I would recommend going Sudden Impact. Next is Eyeball Collection. To be honest, I never really used the other two runes, so I'm not sure how good they are. I saw Eyeball Collection gave damage and I was sold. So I'd say, use whatever you want here. Lastly, I go Relentless Hunter. Usually when I go Electrocute, I go a bursty roaming glass cannon build. And I think the extra movement speed helps me gap close to my targets and maneuver around fights better. Also when it comes to roaming around the map, it helps me get to the parts of the map quicker, and that helps with making picks and being present in fights. Now the secondary tree, we have Triumph. I think Triumph is just too good to pass up. It just synergizes so well with the resets because it helps keep you alive. It can really be the deciding factor whether you win a fight or not. Next is Coup de Grace. Again, it just synergizes well with your game plan. It helps push for kills and can get you resets. Now here you can also take Legend Tenacity if they got some really annoying CCs you have to deal with, like Lissandra ult, Lulu Polymorph, and you combine that with Mercs and you make it a lot easier to deal with. I usually switch it out for Coup de Grace, but you can switch out Triumph if you want, it's all preference. Next page is the Conqueror page. I go Conqueror, Triumph, Legend Tenacity, Last Stand, Secondary Domination with Sudden Impact and Ravenous Hunter. Conqueror is strong in extended fights. The longer you fight, the stronger you get, and when it's fully stacked, it gives you healing as well. It's strong for pushing for all-ins in lane, and also the healing can help you stay alive in team fights. Just like my whole deal with Triumph, it can really decide whether you win a team fight or not. Fairly easy to stack too. You got abilities, auto attacks, auto resets, and your passive daggers, so you got a lot of ways to stack it. And also just like Electrocute, each tick of your ult gives you a Conqueror stack. Now going down the tree, we have Triumph, which synergizes really well with Conqueror because it helps you heal more on top of the healing you already do with Conqueror. Legend Tenacity, just because Tenacity is always nice to have, and the other two runes in this tree aren't really that useful. And now for the bottom tree, you can either go Last Stand or Coup de Grace. I think they're both good. Coup de Grace for the same reasons I've explained before. But Last Stand, because as Katarina, you get focused. So you're often put in a scenario where you're like low, but you have to keep fighting. So it fits the Conqueror playstyle where you're basically healing to stay alive and you're gonna be hovering around low health a lot of the times. And you're basically getting rewarded for it. I'd say Coup de Grace is more consistent, but Last Stand is just cooler, so yeah, I take Last Stand. And for the secondary tree, we have Sudden Impact for the same reasons I've stated before. It gives you the most value out of the other choices, and it's basically free damage. But again, you can also take Taste of Blood if you need for sustain in harder matchups. And lastly, Ravenous Hunter. Ravenous Hunter gives you Omnivamp, and when you use Conqueror, healing's the game. So it's really a no-brainer, just more healing the better. So this is the two rune pages I usually go, but there's other options we can take in the secondary tree that I want to go over real quick that can be viable as well. The other secondary tree I use when not going to standard page is Resolve. Mainly for bone plating, if you play it smart, it can help you win trades against dumb matchups like Fizz and Qiyana, who like to go for short burst trades, and it can help you mitigate a lot of the damage. You generally don't want to take it against champs who can pop your bone plating easily, like for example, Kassadin. So in that case, you could take Second Wind, but in my opinion, it's just better to just avoid poke and take a more useful secondary tree. As a secondary rune, you could either go Revitalize for Conquer or Unflinching for the extra tenacity. So Resolve's just there to make sure you don't get destroyed in lane, so you gotta use it wisely. I'd say the general rule of thumb here is the more you get away with damage, the better. So only use it when you have to. Okay, now let's go over the shards real quick. Double Adaptive Force into Armor or MR, depending on the matchup, is usually what I go. Sometimes taking double armor or double MR is okay in matchups you struggle in, but again, the more you get away with damage, the better. Alright, so we went over the runes. So now it begs the question, when do you take Conquer and when do you take Electrocute? I would say, for me, I like to pick the rune depending on the matchup. I pick whatever rune I feel I can apply the most pressure with to the enemy laner. In a lot of matchups, both runes are viable, so in that case, it comes down to personal preference. But I've made some exceptions for certain matchups where I feel one rune is better than the other. Everyone's matchup knowledge varies, so it really does come down to you and where you excel. But let me throw you an example. Now here's a general idea of what I take into specific champions. This isn't all of them, but I think these are good examples of matchups where I can explain to you what I mean. These are matchups that I'll most likely take one rune over the other. So I take Conquer into matchups where Electrocute isn't effective, and I know that I can only kill these champions in an all-in. Champions like Sylas, Vlad, have good sustain, so it's hard to wither them down with Electrocute because they're just going to heal off the damage. Galio has historically been a pretty rough matchup, but Conquer actually allows you to fight him. Galio likes to hit one of his CCs and then hit you with everything else. But if you're still pretty healthy, or if he whiffs the spell, you can keep fighting him with Conquer. Kassadin has a spell shield, which works well against Electrocute, but he's very vulnerable early game. So with Conquer, you can hard punish him for mispositioning. You also want to have that pressure, because Kassadin scales hard and you want to punish his early game as much as you can. Also, a lot of your damage is going to come from auto attacks, so his spell shield is going to be less effective. Now, when it comes to Electrocute, I take it into generally harder matchups. Matchups where you only have small windows to trade, where the game plan is to poke them out, rather than all in. Champions like Fizz, Akali, LeBlanc, Yasuo have good mobility, so they can outplay your daggers, so it makes it pretty hard for you to set up. Yasuo and Fizz can also beat you in extended fights, so you don't want to challenge that. So you just look for these small windows to hit electrocutes, disengage, and repeat. So if they get aggressive, you want to proc your electrocute and then try to take as little damage as possible. And same idea with when you're getting aggressive, proc electrocute and take as little damage as possible. And then you chunk away at their health until you can look for the all-in. Also remember that you don't need to set up a dagger with electrocute. You can auto-e auto, you can QE auto. Just whip out whatever combo you need in order for you to get it off. Now, taking a specific rune depending on the matchup is one thing, but sometimes you want to take a rune depending on the situation. For example, if the enemy team is filled with tanks that you can't burst, Conquer would be the better option, so you can rack up damage over time. Or if the enemy team is filled with squishies and you can one-shot them, maybe you want to take Electrocute instead, so you can just burst them down and kill them all. Another example would be the elo you're playing in. In lower elo, I think Conquer is strong because you have way more openings to all in, no matter what matchup you're in. In higher elo, players are better and more experienced in the matchup. It may not give you any openings, so Electrocute could be better for still being able to apply pressure in lane. But but also maybe you don't want to play for the lane and rather for team fights and skirmishes instead, because in higher elo it's more about winning skirmishes and fights with Katarina rather than winning lane, because it's pretty hard the higher you climb. So instead you can go conquer, because it is a strong rune for team fights. I'm just saying, remember that there are a lot of factors to the game, and anything could or could not work depending on the situation, the players, the team comps. So keep an open mind, build your own ideas, and keep growing as a player. So that was my rune guide. I'm going to be doing more of these, so if you're trying to learn cat, subscribe for more. If you learned anything and want to give me a small tip, like the video, and comment down below what kind of videos you want me to make in the future. Just letting you know, more guides and Katarina and Lo-Fi are coming. Thank you guys, I will see you later.